A strong Raman signal level is of key importance to the application of Raman imaging. Today, let's continue with the topic of sensitivity, the collection of Raman signal.
To get the best Raman signal, we need to use the strongest possible laser power for excitation that the sample can still withstand. However, in addition to excitation, the collection of Raman signal is equally important. In Raman spectroscopy, photons are scattered elastically in all directions, and unfortunately, we are not able to collect all the Raman scattered photons. But now you might ask, which photons we can detect? We can collect backscattered photons, forward scattered photons, side scattered photons, or their combinations. For instance, we can combine forward scattering and backward scattering by utilizing a concave mirror. However, most Raman researchers make use of the principle of reversibility and limiting themselves to backscattering. In this approach, the backscattered photons will simply travel the same optical path of the laser in the reverse direction. Reuse the laser optics will allow us to realize the simplest optical design, lowest need of maintenance, and of course, the best cost efficiency. In a Raman microscope, we use objective lens for this job. On our objective lens, we can see at least two numbers, magnification and numerical aperture. Numerical aperture describes the range of angles that the lens can accept. Ideally, if numerical aperture equals to 1 in air, this lens can accept 180 degrees, that is 50% of all Raman scattered light. These four can collect 2.3%, 4.2%, 20%, and 28% respectively. And clearly, we choose objective lens with high NA for the best collection of Raman signal. In the next videos, we will see more about signal-to-noise ratio of Raman spectra.